Thank you so much. I'm just tremendously honored, and especially to share this with such distinguished women scientists this year. It's really quite remarkable. So by way of saying thanks, I thought I'd like to share with you a little bit of my own wonder and sense of privilege at having been a part of the 20th century revolution in biology. This started, of course, in 1953 when Watson and Crick proposed the double-stranded structure of DNA. And as you've already heard, I first learned about this as an undergraduate when I worked at MIT in the lab of Alexander Rich, and first heard about this double-stranded structure and was enthralled by the fact that it might provide molecular explanation for the genetics that had fascinated me previously. Nonetheless, I decided that I would apply to medical school, and this was because, again, as you've heard, I looked around. I didn't see any women running labs. I did know a few women physicians. My goals changed only the summer before I was to go to medical school when I worked in the lab of Joe Gall at the University of Minnesota. And by August 1st, I was so excited about the science I was doing, I decided I want to do graduate study. I don't care what the consequences are. So I ended up at Harvard in the laboratory of Jim Watson, who you saw in one of the photos there, and entered a scientific community that at that time was very small, very eclectic. Everybody knew each other. And it was very much focused on studying only the simplest systems, bacteria and their viruses, because it was believed that only by being simple could we ever figure out how life actually worked. In fact, people studying mammalian cells were almost derided for wasting their energies on something that was too complicated to ever understand. So given that that's where I started, it's unimaginable to me what has happened since. The fact that we know the 4 billion base sequence of the human genome and the impact that this has had on medicine, on ecology, evolution, even forensics. It's also unimaginable that there would be a multi-billion dollar biotech industry out there using this science to make products that are benefiting health and human welfare. It's also unimaginable, as I think you've guessed, at that time, that women would ever occupy positions of importance in either science or in university administrations. Another thing that surprised me was how important serendipity is in what happens in science. And it was really just chance findings that set us to using autoantibodies from patients to study these little particles in cells that are necessary for removing the nonsense from messenger RNAs so that they can go out to the cytoplasm and encode proteins. But I think one of the most wonderful surprises about being in science is that I've found that it's almost as much fun to share the joy of discovery with a younger, talented colleague as it is to make a discovery yourself. And I've been blessed over the years with many, many, many very talented younger undergraduates, graduate students, and postdocs. So I feel that they're the reason that I should really be here. And I owe them a lot, and also to the support of my parents, my husband, my son, all my Yale colleagues. Thank you very much.